you in HD by EA Sports and Madden NFL 11. Reliance Stadium in Houston, Texas. I'm Gus Johnson, along with Chris Collinsworth. And welcome to this exhibition clash between the Cowboys and the Texans. Who do you see as the key players for this matchup, Chris?
Well, Gus, I've got my eyes on the two quarterbacks in this one. I had a chance to talk to both of these guys, obviously guys that have experience in this situation. They've been here before, and yet it's always so interesting. You can see a different look in their eyes when they're warming up. You know that they know the significance of these matchups, and it just adds another level of excitement to the football game. When you're talking about this kind of talent on the field, this should be a really good one. I know you're excited. I'm excited. Let's get it going.
Interesting, Chris. Great storyline here today, and we'll follow that storyline as this game moves on. Hands it off straight ahead. It's a gain of 8. Second down. And 2 yards away here on second down. Schaub hands it off. And the tackle was made by Ball.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action, and there's almost no way to stop an offense if you can't stop the run and you have to deal with play action.
Schaub gives it up the middle. He gets to about the 47-yard line. Second down and very short yardage here. The pass is away. Andre Johnson is rocked, and it causes an incompletion.
And that was a good shot. As a receiver, you've got to know you're going to take some hits. You just have to hold on to that ball.
It's third down now, and just about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. Keith Brooking was there for the stop. First down, 10 to go. They hand it off again. 4 yards on that play. That brings up second down. He throws short. Steve Slayton was his intended target. So another third down coming up for the offense. Good coverage downfield. And he's knocked out at the 24-yard line.
When you're trying to blitz the quarterback, you better have some talented corners on the outside, because as a wideout, just give me 3 or 4 seconds against the blitz, and it is awfully tough to try and cover that.
Has a man to his right. Little flip.
So much of the game today revolves around those substitution packages, trying to bring extra defensive backs on the field to try and help against the pass. But when you have a big receiving tight end, that really makes that plan awfully tough to execute.
We're scoreless here at Reliance Stadium after one quarter. So they are now on the 11. He rolls out to the right. Comes down with it. Touchdown.
Let's go, baby. Let's have some fun.
The Texans are able to score the game's first points.
You have to be careful with this offense not to pay too much attention to those great receivers on the outside. Sometimes those tight ends can really be a problem. Boy, did that pay off big.
Brown is good on the point after. Houston is up a score. And here is the drive summary brought to you by Verizon, the official wireless service sponsor of the National Football League. Houston will be kicking off. Jones is deep, looking to return the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. Gets to about the 24 before going down. He passes it. Can't complete that pass.
Good release that time by the receiver at the line of scrimmage, but the pass simply was just not there.
Passes it downfield. He's tackled at the 39-yard line.
You know, a couple of things that really impressed me about Tony Romo. One is his accuracy, and that's always underrated. But the second thing is his quick release. We went back and timed his release and compared it to some of the greatest quarterbacks that ever played the game. And his release is as fast, if not faster, than any of them.
Again, he'll get the call. They pick up 2 yards, and so it will be third down. Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 42. Barely gets it off. He's wrestled down at the 49-yard line. First down and 10. Short throw to the left.
Yeah, when you see the blitz, you have to understand your own protections, because if your protection is sliding away from the blitz, you have no choice but to get it out of there to the hot receiver.
Short pass to his left. Austin was the intended receiver. They line up at the 36. Give to the tailback. Barber picks up about 4 yards on the carry. So they line up at the 32. They pitch it. The stop was made by Mario Williams. Barber gains about 4 yards on the play. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. They'll be looking at a 45-yard field goal. Makes the long one with room to spare.
It really was, wasn't it? There are no field goal kicker jokes going on the sideline right now. Just a lot of love.
Let's take a look at the drive summary, which is presented by Verizon. And he gathers it at the 6-yard line. The Texans got the ball into the end zone on their last possession. For a short throw. Brady James was there to bring him down.
Matt Schaub, a longtime backup, now proving he can get the job done as a starter.
Looks to throw it. And he's gone! Touchdown, Houston!
That's the kind of pitch and catch you just love to see in the NFL. And the difference is these quarterbacks' abilities to zip it into little tight spaces, and these receivers don't miss.
And he adds the point after. Houston gets ready to kick it away. Jones is back to receive the kick. Jones takes it at the 12. He gets back to the 29 before being stopped. He throws downfield. It's almost picked off. Second down coming up after the incomplete pass. Searching for an open man. He's brought down at the 46-yard line. First down and 10. Ball on the 46. Still looking for an open man. Caught and dropped immediately. He laid it in there perfectly. That was a well-thrown ball.
And we talk so much about arm strength for the quarterback position, but sometimes you have to be able to put a little touch on it, and that was pretty.
Comes down with it.
There's just something magical about Tony Romo. There really is. When you talk to him, he has that smile on his face, and he looks like, oh, shucks, and I can't believe this is happening to me. But week in and week out, he makes huge plays in the ball game, and he is a tremendous leader. The Cowboys are picking up nice yardage just about every time they go to the air. I'm not sure what's happening with the defense right now, but they seem a little out of sorts.
First and goal, and the offense needs a touchdown to get back into this game. Jones on the handoff. Touchdown, Cowboys! The Cowboys use six plays and take it 70 yards.
Felix Jones is one of my favorite players in the league. He brings a spark to this offense, and you can see it on plays like that. He just has it.
He misses the extra point. Bueller is just about ready to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. He makes it to the 22.
The Texans looked very strong that last offensive possession. They capped it off with a touchdown. Those are exactly the types of drives coaches love to see, unless you're on the defensive side.
Dallas awaits the kickoff to start the third quarter. He makes it back to about the 31-yard line. He gets off the throw. Stiff arms, and he's brought down. They line up at the 45. Flips it out short to his left. Short gain on that completion. So that will make it second down. They line up at the 46. Has a man short to his left.
Good job all the way around by the defense that time. Not only did they have the deep routes completely covered there, but they also had the check down well within their grasp.
Mario Williams is looking to make a big play on this third and long. Here's the pass. And he's tackled at the 16-yard line. Roy Williams with his third reception. Good gain through the air will set them up with another first down and 10. Here's a halfback. That's a 2-yard gain, and that'll bring up second down. They'll start at the 14. Inside give. Jones picks up about 4 yards on the carry. They're now threatening inside the 10. Hit as he throws. Jason Witten was the intended receiver on the play.
Just missed that time, bringing him down for a sack, but great pressure to force an incompletion.
This isn't much more than an extra point. This will be a 26-yard attempt. The kick is off target.
Ay, 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 ay. When you see your field goal kicker miss one that short, I mean, that's just a gift. You're giving away 3 easy points there.
He's going deep, and the pass is incomplete. The Texans have the ball and the lead as we begin the fourth quarter. Schaub hands it off.
Looked like one of those old-fashioned rugby scrums there. A lot of big bodies piled together and nowhere for the running back to go.
So we gonna take it away.
What? So, it's fourth down. The Texans are lining up to punt it away. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. The Cowboys will begin this drive at the 48-yard line. Handoff up the middle. Passing in this situation seems like it would have been a good idea.
Passing in every situation seems to me like it would be a better idea, but when you have the clock working against you like this, it's time to put it up.
Goes through his progression. No completion that time, and it'll bring up third down. It's now third and six. Flips out short. Cuts back and he's dropped.
It's tough to pay too much attention to a running back in the passing game because at least half the time they're staying in the block. So when they do slip out, occasionally they can hit you for a big play.
Passes it short. Makes a cut, and he will be hit and dropped. First down and 10. The halfback with the carry. Jones picks up about 7 yards on the run. They'll need about 3 yards here on second down. Looking for a man. Nearly picked off. He should have had that one. And now the offense will be faced with a third down situation. The offense needs about 3 yards to get the first here on third down. He gets off the throw. Big play, and the Cowboys will have a first and goal. To the end zone. Touchdown, and they're back on top. They just did exactly what they had to do, and now they're winning this ball game.
And now up one, I'm sure we'll see a 2-point conversion to try and make this a 3-point game.
They'll go for two in this situation. Looks left. Here's a short pass. Great job there. They were able to get it in for two.
And you could tell the offense had a plan throughout that drive. Not only did they get the touchdown, but they immediately got the call in for the 2-point conversion. They knew exactly what they wanted to do and executed it perfectly.
Time for the drive summary. We'd like to let everyone know that this is brought to you by Verizon. It He'll start at the 8-yard line. Gets it to the 21.
The Texans will now go into their 2-minute offense, just down by 3. Plenty of time to work this down the field.
And he's knocked out at the 29-yard line.
Well, they got away with that one. Really not a very good play throwing back across your body like that, but every once in a while you'll sneak that in.
He's going to throw it. He's tackled around the 46-yard line by Terrence Newman. Short pass to his left. He's brought down at about the 45-yard line by Mike Jenkins. Gets it away. Anderson drops it. Who's going to come up with this one? The Texans are going to hold on to it.
Heads up play to get that ball back for the offense. That one really could have gone either way.
Brings it in for a completion.
And running backs who are good receivers are pretty rare. You know, a lot of times those guys, they come out and they're good running the football, but they don't make the kind of plays in the passing game. This guy can clearly do both.
On the ground with the tailback. The Texans will take their first timeout of the half. And they line up at the 28. The Texans call a timeout, and they'll have one timeout left. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The Texans take a timeout, and they call their final timeout of the half. They've got a 2nd and 12 here. They go with the kneel down. That's going to do it from Reliance Stadium. Stay right there for top plays and stats. Here's today's Swagger Player of the Game, presented by Old Spice Deodorant. Smell like a man. Man. Here's one for the highlight reel. It's the Doritos Crunch Time Play of the Game.
This has been a presentation of EA Sports and Madden NFL 11.